Hi, I'm Greg Tito with your guide to the week's hottest news. This is the Escapist News Wrap. GameStop apparently pisses off not only its customers, but its employees too. In a report from a business website that named the worst companies to work for, GameStop ranked number 10 in employee dissatisfaction. The 17,000 poor guys behind the counters of nearly 7,000 stores cited the company's concentration on pre-orders and sales over quality customer service as a big reason why it's a terrible place to work. No wonder GameStop is pushing digital sales. It's a lot harder to piss off your customer over the internet, right? Borderlands 2 wants to make sure you play with your girlfriend. The developers caught flack this week for touting a certain skill tree in the Necromancer DLC class as a much easier mode to play in FPS, calling it the, quote, girlfriend skill tree. Gamers were offended that such a term was used by a designer, but Gearbox president Randy Pitchford quickly tweeted that the tree is meant for a less skilled co-op partner of any gender to play and be useful. That the character in question was designed to look like a cute young girl was just a coincidence. Clearly. This week, BioWare announced new downloadable story content for Mass Effect 3 called Leviathan. The story involves Commander Shepard hunting down a huge space monster that's apparently been eating Reaper ships for sport. It being Mass Effect, though, there might be more going on behind the scenes when a scientist turns up dead. Leviathan comes out August 28th for all platforms and will set you back $10. Now that may sound like a lot of money for downloadable content for a 6-month-old game, but BioWare says that although some gamers complain about DLC, they certainly seem happy enough to buy it. Speaking at GDC in Europe, BioWare's online director said that fans want content and they are willing to pay for it. He also said that the multiplayer transactions for random loot in Mass Effect 3 provided a constant revenue stream and actually makes gamers happier because they can pay what they want, when they want. Speaking of what gamers want, we got a sucker punch this week when an internal Gamescom document listing Half-Life 3 was revealed as a fake. Tons of new game announcements have come from the gaming convention in Germany this week, so it was entirely plausible that the long-anticipated sequel would finally be announced. Unfortunately, representatives admitted the list was just an error, which was supported by the inclusion of Dragon Age 3, Daikatana 2, and Ishtar the video game on that list. We did get some real Valve news this week when they announced and subsequently released a new co-op mode for Team Fortress 2 called Man vs. Machine. You can now team up with friends to defeat waves of robots led by the mysterious Gray Man, all with the trademark humor and style of the series. As with the rest of Team Fortress 2, the co-op mode is free to play and supported with Valve's hat-based economy. A judge in the United Kingdom sentenced a man to 4 years in prison for merely providing links to copyrighted material. Anton Vickerman of SurfTheChannel.com earned advertising income by pointing customers where to illegally download movies and TV shows. The severe sentence for Vickerman was not popular in the UK, but anti-piracy officials said the case served as a harsh example for anyone who profited from illegal copies of material created by someone else. In some happier news, the movie rights to the character Daredevil may be returning to Marvel Studios soon. Joe Carnahan, the man who made The Grey, pitched a 1970s-themed reboot designed to distance the new film from the awful Ben Affleck movie. After Fox failed to greenlight that project, Marvel retains the rights to the character because the contract stipulates a movie must be in the works by October of this year. That may not mean Daredevil will make an appearance in the Avengers continuity everyone's talking about, but it's not outside the realm of possibility for Matt Murdock to have drinks with Tony Stark and Dr. Bruce Banner in Avengers 2. And we can all be happy about that. That's our news wrap for this week. Stay tuned to escapistmagazine.com for all the latest gaming news.